Have you ever plugged in a USB drive and seen this vague message come up about a problem with this drive, and wonder, like, what does that even mean? Is the drive failing? Should I be worried? Well, you're about to find out exactly what it truly means, even behind the scenes. But don't worry, even though I'll show you the technical stuff, it's actually really easy to understand, even if you don't know much about computers. So, let's get into it. First, I'll show you what actually causes this message to appear, and how Windows knows that there is a problem, and even how to remove it in a way you're really not supposed to. Okay, so first, what exactly does Windows see that makes it decide that there is a problem with a USB drive? Well, it's actually checking for one very specific thing. In fact, it looks at one very special byte of data at a special location on the drive called the dirty bit. And it's very simple. If you plug in a drive and Windows looks and sees that this dirty bit is set to 1, it shows the warning. If it's set to 0, it doesn't. And you could actually use this built-in Windows command in the command prompt, fsutil dirty query, and then the drive letter, and it will tell you whether the drive is marked as dirty or not. And we'll even take a look at the actual hex data later and see the change for ourselves. Of course, this begs the question, what might cause this dirty bit to change from 0 to 1? And fortunately, that is also really easy to explain, even at a technical level. But I will tell you, first of all, no, it's probably not that the drive is failing. Though I'm sure a lot of you are going to guess at this point, well, obviously, it's from unplugging the drive without ejecting it first. And while you're not wrong per se, it is a bit more nuanced than that. You might never bother to eject your USB drives and still never see this error. It will all become clear in a minute, though. Now, as a side note, besides problems with USB drives, another problem we all encounter is the insane amount of shopping scams these days, which is where today's sponsor can help, Bitdefender. You see, scams are getting harder to spot. For a couple examples, scammers will often create entire fake online stores with bogus deals, like these fake Halloween sales. I mean, I guess even the scammers get in on the holiday spirit, just more evil. Or they'll even often pay to run scam ads to their fake websites. According to the Better Business Bureau, 40% of online shopping scams originate from Facebook and Instagram ads. But besides the usual advice to stick to reputable retailers and double-check the web URLs, what can you do to protect yourself? Well, fortunately, Bitdefender has your back. They have a new free scam-detecting chatbot called Scamio, specially trained to spot all sorts of scams you might not even be aware of. If a website looks suspicious, or you think an online seller is trying to scam you, just provide Scamio with info about what's going on, and it can analyze the situation. You can show it text messages, links, QR codes, even images and screenshots. And like I said, Scamio is totally free and accessible not just via a web browser, but also Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, even Discord. Of course, Bitdefender also has a whole range of security solutions to protect your devices from malware and hackers for both individuals and businesses. So visit the link in the description to check out Bitdefender's new Scamio AI Scam Detector chatbot for free, and also check out their other security solutions. And with all that being said, let's continue. Okay, so enough beating around the bush. What causes this dirty bit to get activated on storage drives? Well, it's basically just a way for Windows and other applications to keep track of whether or not data was being written to the drive and whether that transfer was properly finished. If you go to copy a file to a drive using Windows Explorer or some other application, it will first set that dirty bit to a value of 1 and then start copying the file, and only when it's finished, it will set it back to 0 again. The idea being that if you plug in a USB drive and the dirty bit is already 1, then that means that apparently something went wrong in the middle of transferring data to it before, at some point, whether the drive was unplugged or potentially just the program crashed while writing. In any case, that means there's a good chance that at least one of the files on the drive was corrupted, assuming that there weren't multiple programs writing multiple files in parallel at the same time. So if Windows sees the dirty bit as 1 when it's plugged in, it shows that warning, and that is the problem that it's talking about. And that scan that it runs is basically just check disk. It just does a scan and repair for the integrity based on the file system. And you can actually run the scan through the properties of the drive, whether it detected a problem or not. It'll just say that it's not really necessary, but you can anyway. Here is something interesting though. The fsutil command I showed you before, you can actually manually enable the dirty bit on a drive using that. You just do fsutil dirty set and then the drive letter. But be aware that this tool can only enable the dirty bit. You can't disable it. I guess the reason is it might be too tempting for some people to just mark it as fine instead of doing the actual scan. Anyway, if I do set it on the drive here, you can see that it's now marked as dirty. And then if I unplug and plug it back in right away, it says that there is a problem with this drive. So let's take a closer look and see this bit change for ourselves. I'll use this hex editor called imhex. It's free and open source, and it lets you see the raw data on drives. And don't worry if you don't know any of what this is that you're looking at. We're only interested in one thing here. And of course, don't mess around with this if you don't know what you're doing in any case. Now, one neat thing about this program is it lets you load patterns that basically tells the program where these different bytes are for different file formats, so you can like kind of identify it. And I made this one for the FAT32 file system boot sector. Of course, you don't need to know all this, but since I know people will ask, I'll put a link to the hexpat pattern, it's called, in the description if you want it. Anyway, we can see based on the pattern highlighting that the dirty bit is located exactly here. And since I use that command to enable it, it is indeed set to 1. And now what I can do is close this so Windows can access the drive again, and then run the scan to repair it, which takes no time because it was empty. And now if we open the hex data back up, we can now see that the dirty bit is 0 again. The scan fixed it. Now, I know what you're thinking. Can you change the hex data here? And actually, yes, but please do not do this. I don't know if there's any maybe side effects. I'm just going to be doing this on an empty drive for demonstration only. Now, changing this from 0 to 1 basically does the same thing as that fsutil command. And then if we use that to check it again, of course, it says that it is dirty, as expected. And now I'm going to do something a bit naughty and manually change the dirty bit to disable it instead of using the repair scan. Of course, you should never do this for the reasons I talked about in this entire video. Anyway, if I go back in and change it from 01 to 00, then close it, and run the command to check it again, it now says that it is not dirty, without even running the scan. And the properties menu says that it hasn't found any errors also. So now, a final couple points. If you're wondering, yes, the best way to avoid this kind of error warning is actually to use the USB eject feature. That basically just ensures that all write operations are completed before it disconnects it. Because it might not be always obvious when data is being accessed on there or written. It might not necessarily be because you're actually copying a file over, but maybe some program is reading the files and then updating some metadata and writing it that way. Though I believe just reading the data and accessing it doesn't set the dirty bit, it's only if it's writing something, but it might be like metadata, like I said. If you do often see this error message come up on drives and you aren't actively copying files to it, there probably is some program that you have installed or are actively using that for whatever reason is accessing the drive and writing stuff to it. And it might not be important data necessarily, but also don't assume that just because you can see all the files in there and seemingly open them, that the error must be wrong, so you can just ignore it. It doesn't mean that the whole drive is dead, it just means that there might be some corruption in there. So you should still do the scan and be sure to eject it properly if you can get in the habit of it. One final fun fact, if you're wondering why it seems that nothing bad happens when you force a shutdown of your computer or have a power loss, it's actually that ever since Windows Vista, Windows has used a technology called self-healing NTFS, which I'm not going to get into, but basically the file system that's used by Windows has some features that does stuff like not deleting the original data until a transfer from one location is completed, so that even if there is a failure, it can automatically recover it. But that's just one example of it. There's other stuff. And if you're old enough to remember in the Windows XP days, if you did a forced shutdown, then on the next reboot, every time it would tell you to run check disk, and that could potentially take a really long time. But you don't really see that these days because of this, all this technology built in behind the scenes, unless something is really wrong with the drive. So you don't have to necessarily say that Windows Vista was all bad. That's kind of when they added that feature in. So I would be curious to know what you guys all think. Do you ever see this error often, and what did you think it was? And do you actually run the scans? And maybe you'll think about actually ejecting the drive. We can talk about that all down in the comments. Also, thanks again to Bitdefender for sponsoring. Be sure to check out their free Scamio AI Scam Detector chatbot and other security solutions by visiting the link in the description. If you want to keep watching, the next video I recommend is where I had some fun breaking the Windows clipboard. if you want to know what I mean by that, you'll just have to watch that video by clicking there. So I think you'll enjoy that. I'll see you over there. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.